Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
Agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country? I flew in business class from Manaus. Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
You should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving UNIDAD and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pacatari, as soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers, this is the help you promised? That's on the wall promised? A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pacatari, leader of the resistance group Kataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Kataris 26.
More than that, our group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he's in this province and that there's a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pacatari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find the Maru.
Hoo-ah.
May Santa Muerte bless you. Amen.
To the market, Jeeves.
Thank you. tangos. Danger close.
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Shit, we got company.
Good, all clear.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move. Just spotted one with submachine guns. Hostile down. I got a target carrying submachine guns.
All clear, all clear. That's a hostile presence. Got a Sicario at the foot of the watchtower.
That's a kill.
We're good, we're good.
Got another tango.
He's history. Is no threat to anybody.
Silencio, marche.
Pinche cabrón.
Está bien, me rindo. Careful, Sicario sporting a submachine gun next to the sandbag emplacement.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón! What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru is a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move. That's a kill. Let's get moving. Cartel isn't gonna hold on.
We good? Shit got close for a second there.
Let's get moving. The cartel isn't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Coming back from a non-stop block of tunes. That last track brought me back, vatos. I was remembering this time me and my boy Javi went to this party on that East 38th Street hood in LA. We didn't roll with those carnales, but I was sweating this mora whose brother was in with them real deep. Javi and me was like 15 or something, 14. And like the young blood we were, we wanted to come through the door looking hard, cabrones pues. But Javi, man, that fucker was always stoned. So when we were on the way there, he saw this red taco truck on the corner. His case of the munchies made him stop for a fucking enchilada. Yo, after he ate, we rolled through the door of that party in our crispy white tees and our fucking 501s, and I thought we looked dope. Those plebs were about 2 seconds away from giving us that upward head nod that means respect, right? But then, fucking Javi runs through the party, shoving motherfuckers aside, knocking bitches over, and he jumps into the bathroom and lets loose with diarrhea so goddamn explosive, I swear to God you could hear it over the music. We sure as fuck didn't look so duro then, and I sure as fuck wasn't gonna get with that vieja I was sweating. So I turned my ass around and left that party before any motherfucker could ask my name. As for Javi, he made it out alive. Turns out, all those vatos knew that red taco truck and knew it was bad news, so they felt bad for the pendejo. If I remember right, they actually jumped him in a month later. This is DJ Perico, getting nostalgic on Santa Blanca Radio.
¿Por qué no formar parte de la verdadera elite mundial que rige al mundo? Ten y entrénate para ganar, porque lo único que tienes es hoy. Ten y vivirás al máximo.
Las me...
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Shit, he knows he's taking fire.
Boom, target down.
Exijo que me saquen ahora mismo de aquí, bestias.
Target marked. Keep an eye on your background.
Sé que están ahí. Así que escuchen bien.
We're clear.
No, perdona.
Pensará mi familia. Se acordará de mí.
¿Creerán que he muerto?
Hasta lo que fuera por hablar con ellos.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
Hey, ¿qué pasa?
We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up these supplies later.
Sure are a lot of lights and switches up here.
Hola.
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor.
There's an Air Force colonel and a Delta operator sitting next to each other on a flight out of King Khalid.
Is this the one where the Delta operator skins the Air Force colonel and wears him like a suit?
What? No. The Delta guy's been out in the desert doing, you know, Delta stuff.
This is it.
Hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si, Yuri Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through. That's the run.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency, and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchan named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop, for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
Done on La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño.
El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head Sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
Shooting these Escort car has been destroyed.
We need what's in that truck. Don't blow it up.
Don't hit the truck.
Movement on the road.
Inside of it.
Looks like an UNIDAD convoy. I'm seeing troops plus a radio truck.
We can take out the convoy and turn the radio gear over to the rebels.
The combo gear's in good shape. We'll pass on the location of the truck to the rebels. Pack, this is Nomad. The convoy is secure.
Gracias, amigo. My people will make good use of those supplies. My people are searching for La Yuri y El Polito, but in the meantime, there is something else you can do for us. I have prepared a speech for the people of Bolivia. It is a call to arms that we will broadcast from Itaqua.
Santa Blanca is going to send troops to shut that down as soon as they hear the transmission.
You see my problem? I need someone dependable to find a radio transmitter and protect it until the broadcast is complete.
Okay, Qatari. We'll get it done. Sorry about this, brother, but I gotta have the car. Out. The rebels need supplies badly, and that chopper's got them. Let's snag that bird and get it turned in the right direction. Let's roll.
Go on, I'll meet you.
Target carrying submachine guns.
Two Sicarios. Over there,
spotting another
next
tango.
To the container.
Marking a tango. He's close to that local.
Marvin.
Esta gente no le importa nada ya.
¿Qué rollo, carnales? Listen up for special message from el sueño.
Brothers and sisters, hermanos. Bolivia has been good to us, and it is the nature of Santa Blanca to return a generosity in provinces where we are operating.
Hostile down.
He's over 65 years of age with a Santa Blanca pension. God willing, all reach of advanced age, and we all deserve to live out the last years in comfort. As long as the individual does not have a history of aiding Pacatari and the rebels, the cartel will aid him or her. When your government leaves your parents or grandparents to fend for themselves, Santa Blanca will provide.
Eyes on a narco with a submachine gun.
Where you got him? Go down.
They're on alert. I have a shot. Engage. Get the hell out of there!
I got one of those cartel medals here. Some sicario is gonna miss this.
We got tangos. Danger close. There's a sicario over here.
Point him out.
There, on the bridge.
We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up these supplies later. Got the route of a cartel supply chopper here. Should make it easy to intercept and reroute it towards the rebels. Let's get to it.
Eyes on a cartel lieutenant, by the ruins. Narco with a damn minigun.
I don't see him.
Near the ruins.
Go down.
Oh,
Hostile killed.
Shit got close for a second there.
Pakatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to count on his support in the future.
Pakatari and his rebels. These promises of equality and transparency, or free education and free health care, they are empty hopes that can only be achieved through tyranny. Out of your labor, take the largest portion for himself. Divide what is left between you and your neighbor. Tengan cuidado. You would not reap what you have sown for your economy. Contrary to the lies
of history.
That was fucking close. I got one narco. Near that turret. You're gonna get made. Hang back. All right, three easy.
That's a kill. Hold still.
Okay, okay.
Got eyes on the tank. Tango down.
Gracias.
Marking target. Watch the background.
It's a pleasure to be talking with you.
Now, can you confirm or deny these exciting rumors floating around the campfires about a new submersible that El Cerebro's cooking up?
El Cerebro?
Right below the surface of the water.
Pues sí, papacito, it is true. He has constructed for us...
Yo, cartel gunman. Over by that stack of tires.
...visible to radar and satellite imaging. It is a working prototype, and within weeks, we may have these submersibles exporting our product to Mexico and Europe.
And the question everyone is asking, will these new narcos sell that bathrooms?
No.
Ahí lo tienen. The truth straight from the lovely lady's mouth. And now, back to the music that makes your culo bounce up and down.
Target down.
I have a shot. Grenade!
frag out.
Grenade,
I'm
here
to culeros.
Grenade! Get down!
Who's up for plugging a rebel radio station back in? Got the location of a dead one right here.
Pacatari's got some brass ones, I'll give him that. Give that fucker an inch and he'll take a mile.
If he can get us to Yuri and Polito, it's worth it. Let's get it done.
Jorge, en Inca Camina, has to say on top. I will hear your confession.
Hang on, I'll drive.
Perhaps then, Santa Muerte will forgive you.
I don't know any...
I'm in. What the shit? That's Pax guy.
Dios mío! My foot! Give it back! Por favor! Listo! Listo, listo!
Their LT is trying to run.
Check your fucking targets. That's a civilian. No reason to waste rounds. We done? Shit, kinda got all excited there.
This document mentions an Unidad captain who sends prisoners to Yuri and Polito for interrogations. He's got to know where our lovebirds are, but he's sitting in the Unidad firebase.
Most of you know the medically trained couple got started in Santa Blanca after they saved the life of our very own La Plaga. What many of you may not know is that soon after Yuri and Polito met at the hospital where they both worked, Yuri filed a sexual harassment lawsuit against Polito. The reason? Yuri wanted Polito to pay more attention to her! Pinche Yuri! I guess...
Civilians in the area. Watch your targets.
Cartel assholes. What the fuck is wrong with these people?
Hermanos, fellow cocaleros, I look at your faces and I see the scars the men of the Santa Blanca have left on this land. Stealing our coca. Threatening our way of life.
Got eyes on the tango. He's got a lot of background.
Murdering our
marking
children.
A hostile. He's close to some local.
A trail of
his history.
Tango knows somebody's got a bead on him. Clear.
Is it too much to ask to be able to raise our children without them lying awake every night listening? Must we lie awake as well? Wondering if a stray bullet might come through their bedroom walls and take them from us? If we do not take our country back, those bullets will find us.
Tango's dead.
That emitter.
You're gonna be alright, you hear me?
Our families disappeared, and no one does anything.
That emitter's taking a lot of damage, man.
Across our great country. But we know it is lies, and we are not afraid! Join us, hermanos, and we will solve these problems!
Drag out! Shit balls. Target down.
The cartel's tyranny. Don't let these Santa Blanca monsters take another one of us without repercussions.
Tari got his message out. That should get his people stirred up.
Compadre, I may have someone who can give you information on Yuri and Pulito.
I'm listening.
One of my lieutenants managed to escape from them. He fled to a village called Curta. Rather than give my man up to the cartel, the villagers hit him.
Goddamn bravery right there.
In response, Santa Blanca razed every home and executed all the villagers.
Fuck.
My lieutenant is still being kept alive. Probably so he can be killed in an even more painful way.
Understood. We're heading to Curta now. Tango down.
Hola, puto. Ya te vi. Ya sé quién eres. Ya le va a cargar la verga a tu familia.
Well done, compadres. My speech was heard all over Bolivia. It is only a matter of time before the people rise up and join our cause. Viva la revolución.
Glad we could help. Now, what have you got on Yuri and Polito?
Nothing yet, amigo. Those two, they cover their tracks well. But my people are working on it. We will know something soon. In the meantime, my revolutionary brothers in Itaqua stand ready to help if you need them. Just call, and they will come.
I'll keep that in mind.
Of Colta might have valuable intel on Luyuri and El Polito. Rescue him from the cartel and find out what he knows.
Nidia Flores, mamacita de mi vida, that hangs around right below the surface of the water.
Pues sí, papacito, it is true. He has constructed for us a fully
I gotta say, I feel bad for Agent Sandy. But that guy was crazy. I mean, his balls must have knocked against his knees. They were so big.
6 years undercover, that's damn brutal.
Think of all the evil shit he must have done to become swift. an eye out for the rebel they've got held here.
Seeing two narcos here, by the church.
Keep quiet.
Chinga la verga!
Down, you're giving yourself away.
History. Sniper out there.
Looks like we riled them up. We know we're here. Be careful.
Down. Boom, target down. Fucking hell! Frag out. Tango down. Stay quiet.
Yo no he hecho. Hola, puto. Ya te vi. Ya.
To kill.
We're clear over here. God, these fuckers are sloppy.
Hey, hey, abre la puerta, compa. Open the door.
You okay, hermano?
What do you want from me?
Yuri and Polito, the fuckers who tortured you. We're here to make them pay for what they did. But we need to know where they took you.
We didn't travel far. I remembered that much, and it was quiet. Out in the country somewhere. There was a smell, like old animal skins. That's all I know. I'm sorry.
It's all right. At least now we know they're close by. Gracias.